Hi guys, this is Rahul Prajapati and welcome to another demo video. In today's session, we are going to discuss another pro tool that is backtesting. You know, as an option trader, we always need to test our strategies based on different market scenarios. So specifically, we have created one very powerful system under which we can backtest any specific strategy on specifically options. So in this way, you can, you know, by using this particular tool, you can backtest any particular strategy under which you can test from even from you know from less probably from last 4 or 5 years data to have a edge over other people that you know the ins and outs of the that particular strategy. So I'll show you how this particular backtesting tool works and how can we use this particular to test any particular strategy. Now let's see how this works. So we'll go to the Quantsap and we'll search backtester. So backtesting. Okay. Now let's see how this particular thing works, and then we'll see what are the different things, variables we need to add to get to the results of the strategy. Now first, select a symbol. So let's say I'll go with the Reliance. Okay. Now, so I need to test it. Let's say from starting for 2018. Okay, so 1st January 2018 to till today's right last day. Okay, now I need to select the expiry also. So let's say the expiries I'm taking monthly, and we can take the weekly expiry for indices also, but stocks we need to take the monthly. Okay, now we need to tell this particular tool that before expiry, how many days before the expiry we are actually executing the trade. Let's say I'm executing 20 days before every expiry. Okay, I'm executing this trade 20 days. Now you can specifically give the requirement based on OI and volume. If you click on this, that means you are accepting any OI above zero. That is, even one will consider, and volume could be again same thing, right? Now the second thing is, this is the initiation, right? Okay, second is trade exit. Now even sometimes we want to exit some trades before the the expiry, or if you want to execute or exit this particular strategy specifically on the expiry date, so we need to put here zero. Okay, and you can specify your target also. If you leave it, that will be perfectly fine. We will be executing the trade on the last day specifically. Okay, now we need to add the length. So what should we do? We should be let's try to backtest some strategies, right? So first let's do the short straddle. Okay, so we'll be doing the short straddle. Okay, so short straddle. Okay, now so what is short straddle, under which it in this particular strategy we might have discussed earlier also. So in this particular strategy we are selling at the money call option, at the money put option. Okay, both the things, right? So how do we add it? Now we'll go to the add lengths. Okay, now Reliance 250, that is the lot size. Okay, you can increase the quantity also if you want. Let's say you want to do 5 lot, 10 lots, whatever, right? Now I clicked on, I selected 250. Now first I need to select the call option. Okay, and I will sell it because this is a short strategy. Okay, now you can select this particular thing from the strike or delta. Okay, so if you select the strike, that means we need to give this particular tool that we want which strike price to be tested specifically. So if I put zero here, that means it is selecting ATM. Okay, if I'm selecting plus one, that means it will select the next expiry, whatever it will be. Okay, sorry, next strike, whatever it will be. Let's say at that point of time the current expiry was 1,000 rupees, the strike price was 1,000. Okay, and the next expiry was, let's say, 1,100. So if I put one here, right, so it will pick up this one, fine. That is the thing, this is how it works. Okay, so if you want to, let's say, test the third the strike price from the current market price, so we can put three here and we'll get this particular the strike price here. So I'm just selecting at the money because straddle is always created on at the money. Okay, so we have selected the strike and at the money, so add leg. Okay, so first leg has been added. Now I'll do the same thing for put option also. Strike, sell, zero. Okay, now we'll go to the back test and we'll execute this trade. Okay, now we'll get this whole statistics right. Okay, so the strike rate is 52%, total P&L 40,000, profit factor 1.8. Okay, so we have total count of 42 trades as it is showing the 52 strike rate. That means 50% trades are right, 50% trades are wrong, right? Average P&L is 12,000, right? Maximum loss, maximum profit, that is total profit is 271. And again, same thing for this. Now, this is the graph. This is how it works. Started from zero, it went in the profit, again in loss. And this is the maximum drawdown here. Okay. And then market went up. So this, sorry, this profit and loss went up. So this is your P&L curve. Okay. Now, you can see this in the, you know, the histogram also. Okay. Now, you can check the tabular view. Now, here you will get the every detail of your trade, how the trade has been executed, right? Now, this is the current one. Okay, so this is this trade. This is for the this trade executed 20 days before, that is 4th June. So we sold this, so we got in profit. So we are totally in profit in this month. Likewise, in the last month also, likewise in the, you know, the month before, in that previous, in the March, we were in loss. Okay, so the stock might went up, right? Probably it has break, you know, move above the break-even point. So this is how it works, right? So we'll get every particular strike price at that point of time. The stock might be trading at 2200. So you'll get the trade accordingly. Okay. So, you know, you'll get the total profit and loss because in June, the stock remained somewhere around 2200 only. So it was that. Now, at that point of time, market was in May, the stock was 1940. So it has taken that strike price. In April, it was somewhere around 2000. So that's why it has taken that strike price. So accordingly, it will pick up the strike price at that point of time, that is 18. Okay. So this is how it works. You can check any particular strategy. You can try any particular strategy. Okay. Now, let's try you know, one bull call spread also for any particular stock. Let's say we'll go for Tata Steel. Okay. Now, so again, monthly 20 days before, and same thing, we'll add the leg. Okay. So call, zero strike price. At the money, we will buy. Okay. And we will be selling the, let's say, let's go with the third leg, okay, or let's say fifth leg, call. Okay, so we'll selling this, fine. So this whole things are same, right? So let's test it. So one we have selected a buy leg and one we have selected a sell leg in this. Okay, now we have our profitability dropped in this case because the strategy didn't work out in the starter still. So we tried to get some profit sometimes when market was trending. When market was not trending, we lost it, okay, because market didn't move as per our requirement. So we can change the date also. Let's say I wanted to test only from 2020. Okay, so let's say I want to test only just the last year and the current one. So I'll start with 1st January and I'll backtest it now. Okay, now bit of improvement. Total out of 18 trades, we have 10 wrong trades and we have, you know, 8 correct trades. Accordingly, we have this. So this is how the whole data looks like, right? Okay. You can check in the graphical view also and curve also. So probably it started going up from here only, November, because the stock become trending at that point. So you have a good upside here. So this is how it works, right? Now let's try one monthly, weekly expiry also on Nifty. Okay. Now we'll do you know, butterfly or some kind of that strategy. Let's try that. Okay. So weekly, because, you know, generally if you are talking in terms of weekly expiry, what is happening? We are just, you know, market likely to be, you know, trade in a range most of the time. So a selling strategy would work out in this case. So let's see how it works. So weekly strategy, we'll be, you know, executing trades always on, let's say, on Monday specifically. So we have 4 days. Okay, so Nifty, now let's add legs. So we'll be selling, let's make from the here only. So we'll do 2 legs, 150. So we are selling 2 legs here, zero. Okay, okay, now we'll add another leg. So that is 75 only. So now this is how it works in butterfly. What we do, I'm creating a butterfly here. So ATM, we are selling 2 lots, okay? OTM, we will buy 1 lot, and ITM, we will buy 1 lot. Okay, this is how it works. So we'll try to test this strategy, okay? And this is based on call. You can create same strategy on put also. There will be hardly any difference, okay? So let's see, let me just do it. So two strike price above, I'll buy. Okay. So minus two. Okay, so two strike price below. So we can even select the higher delta also in that case. Okay, fine. So let's test this strategy. So because there are multiple legs, it will take time, but you will get this. Now, not a good strike rate as such, because we were mostly in the loss here. So you can check this strategies. Okay. So at the money, this has selected. So it has sold this one and it has, you know, bought this one. So it has, you know, basically moved into this. So we can even do, because, you know, the rate is at this point of time, it is considering 750 also, 650 also. So we can change it also if you want to. Although we are not in loss, we are break even totally, right? Okay, so how do we do it? We change it. Let's say, let's move it to 4. Okay, so, or let's say 5. So you can manipulate this, you know, this particular system according to your needs and then see how market works. So this is how, you know, you will help, it will help you. You can test any strategy here and, you know, you can get the result out of it, even from, you know, that time. Now see, it's better now. Probably better right now. So a lot of time we have got profit, a lot of time we have loss also, but so again the 50-50% rate here. Okay, now one more thing we need to focus here is that two things. First, this strategy always consider the, you know, the closing prices. Okay, so we cannot do the intraday backtesting specifically. Okay, now so it will always consider that thing from, you know, initial point. That means, let's say you have initiated the strategy on Monday, so it will always be considering the close day on expiry, right? Okay, if you want to do it, let's say if you want to exit only, let's say you want to execute this only trade only 2 days before and zero, right? So we can do this also. Let's do this short straddle again for Nifty on weekly expiry, call option. So put option zero. Okay, so just 2 days before, you know, we are executing the trade because the theta decay is always high in the last 2 days. So let's see how this turns out to be. Okay. Now bit of improvement because most of the time market remain in the range, so that's why we are getting this. Now there are two specifically, I won't say drawback, but what we cannot do in this. The whenever we are putting some values here, it will always consider the strategies of the same expiry. We cannot trade, you know, some other, you know, you can say a strategies for, you know, by including the other expiry also. Let's say we are taking one, like whenever we create calendar split, so we always consider first, you know, the current month expiry and the next month expiry or the current week expiry or the next week expiry. So that we cannot backtest here. So you need to select all those strategies which are actually, you know, based on one particular expiry, same expiry, okay? And the second is, here you can do it that it will always consider the closing price, okay? It will not be, you know, helpful in the intraday specifically. So that's all. That's all from this particular strategy backtester. Try this and, you know, you can test different back, you know, option strategies and see how they work. And you can test on any particular script, right? Okay. So that's all from the backtesting. Guys, I'll see you again on the next video. Till then, stay safe and thank you so much.